We'll see now the second experiment in control system, that is synchro transmitter receiver pin. Okay. The objective of this experiment is to find the relation between synchro as a transmitter and receiver pin. Okay. So here you can see the front panel details of this synchro transmitter receiver pair. Okay. So in this kit we have two motors. So one is act as a transmitter and another is act as a receiver. So before seeing this kit, we'll see what is meant by synchro first. So synchro is an electromagnetic transducer which converts angular displacement of the shaft into an electrical signals. Okay, it is commercially also called as a self sync or auto sync. So these kind of motors are used in transmission of angular position in transmission systems. Okay, so here you can see first part. This part indicates the synchro as a transmitter. As I told, it is similar to an alternator. Okay, it has two parts. One is the stator and another one is the rotor. Okay, here you can see the stator rotor position. Okay, so there will be three stator windings. One is S1, S2, S3. So between any two stator windings, the angular displacement will be 120 degree. Okay, so as we vary the rotor angular position of this shaft, okay, the voltage across S1, S2, S3 will be varied accordingly. So okay, so first we'll see the operation of synchro as a transmitter now. Okay, this part indicates the synchro as a transmitter, and this part indicates synchro as a receiver. So we have two motors. So one acts as a transmitter and another acts as a receiver. So here you can see this is a LCD display. So it is also called as a voltmeter, which will measure the voltage between any two stator windings. Okay, so we'll connect these stator windings to the voltmeter first. So connect S1, S2 of these stator windings to the voltmeter. Okay, so now it is connected. So here you can see the angular position of the rotor from 0 to 360 degree. Okay, so before varying the angular position, so switch on the transmitter motor. Okay, so now we can see the rotor angular position is at 0 degree. Okay, so for 0 degree, the voltage between S1 and S2 is 12 volts. So now I will connect the stator windings S2, S3. So now for 0 degree, the voltage between the S2, S3 will be 10 volts. So for 0 degree rotor angular position, the voltage between S1 and S2 is 12 volts. So now I will increase the rotor angular position to 30 degree. So for 30 degree, you can see the voltage between the stator windings S1 and S2 is decreased to 9 volts. So as I told, as you vary the angular position of the rotor part, the voltage at the stator will be varied. Okay, so now I will set the stator rotor windings at 60 degree. You can see now it is almost 0 volt. Okay, so now as we increase the value of rotor angular position, the continuously we can get the voltage, different voltage across the stator windings. So this is how we can vary the value of voltage between S1 S2. So similar thing can be happened for S2 S3 voltage. Okay, for S2 S3 also we can vary the value of stator voltage by varying the rotor angular positions. And last one is for S3 S1. Okay, we can get the three set of readings. So for different angular positions from 30 degree to 360 degree, we can get the value of different stator voltages S1, S2, S2, S3, S3, S1. Okay, so this is the synchro as a transmitter, first part in the synchro pair characteristics. Okay, so next part is synchro as a transmitter and receiver. Okay, so to find the relation, we need to short circuit the stator windings of both the motors. Okay, we have three stator windings for transmitter and three stator windings for receiver. To find the relation between synchro as a transmitter, the stator windings of both the motor and transmitter and motor receiver will be short circuited. So here you can see the S1, S1 of both the motors will be short circuited. Okay, so as we vary the angular position of the rotor, first transmitter, the same angle will be received at the receiver side. Here you can see, I am varying the rotor angular position of the transmitter, the same angle will be varied at the receiver part. Okay, so we will set the angular position of the transmitter to 60 degree. So now it is around, we are getting around 30 to 40 degree. There will be 10 to 15% of error. Okay, so now we will increase the value of transmitter rotor angular position to 90 degree. You can see it is also varying with the transmitter angular position. The receiver will be follow the stator angular positions. Okay, so this is how we can sketch the graph between stator and the rotor. About stator synchro as a transmitter and synchro as a receiver, we can draw the graph between voltage versus angular position in case of synchro as a transmitter. Okay, voltage is taken along y-axis and rotor angular position is taken along x-axis. So for different values of stator voltages, we can get the graph like this. Okay, we'll get the three-phase curve in case of synchro as a transmitter. Whereas in case of synchro as a transmitter and receiver, the receiver angle is taken along y-axis and transmitter angle is taken along x-axis. So as we vary the rotor angular position of the transmitter, the same angle will be received at the receiver side. So hence the characteristics is almost linear between synchro as a transmitter and receiver pair. Okay, so this is the objective of the experiment. Thank you.